What's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Spitting Venom, aka the Venom Vlog. And again, we are back with another Marvel Legends series Typhoid Mary toy review from the Venom series that just came out recently. And I know she's the third figure we're going to look at. And I know a lot of you are like, hey, get to Scream, get to Spider-Ham. I promise I'm going to get to all of them, and we're going to do a video separately on the Build-A-Figure. But for now, I just wanted to go through the ones as they were in the order that I stacked them in. And Typhoid Mary was next. And so we have a little biography of her. One of Mary Walker's three distinct identities. Typhoid Mary is a brutal combatant with the disturbing ability to set things on fire with her hand. Definitely makes her a good opponent for Venom. I'm actually surprised they never turned her into a Venom arch enemy. I think they've met once before. I can't remember. There was a Daredevil story called Fall from Grace that they both were in, but I can't remember if they met or not. But she's definitely a cool character. I'd love to see her fight Venom at some point in the comic books, especially with her powers and Venom's weakness to fire. But without further ado, because we've already waited long enough to get to these, let's crack her open and check her out. All right, here she is, Typhoid Mary, looking awesome. I actually love this sword piece that she comes with, and you can actually take the fire off and have it come off her hand or like wherever you want to put it. But it looks great that it you can detach it. That way, if you just want to pose her with the sword, you have that option. And I always love when figures and toys give you options to do things and that they didn't just mold that in there, because as cool as it looks, I'm sure some people would like to take it off or maybe give the sword to another character, whatever they want to do. Everyone likes to customize stuff in their own way, so it's nice that that's an option. But you see her here in this outfit, and I don't know exactly which comic version this is from. I'll be completely honest with you. I read Daredevil from time to time, but the only complete run I think I've ever read of the character is probably the Frank Miller stuff, and then I think the Brian Michael Bendis stuff, and anywhere in between there and anything after, I've only picked up an issue here or there. I really like the character of Daredevil, but I don't always like stories that are told with him. I think some stories kind of like, you know, I get pulled away pretty easily from him. So it depends on what kind of writer and what kind of story they're telling. And that's the only way I really stick in and plant my feet and read the whole run. But Typhoid Mary, she's also a character I don't see a ton of for that reason. And so if any of you guys have a favorite moment of hers in the comic, or you know exactly what costume version this is based off of, let me know, because I've seen various different versions of the character over the years, and but I don't know if I've ever remembered this one. It looks kind of classic, but with some modern, you know, flair to it, some shoulder pads on there, so I just don't recognize this version. So let me know down in the comments. But she looks great. She has all the articulation points that every figure has. She's got the shoulder joint on a ball joint, she's got her elbow, she's got her hand, which also you know, rotates back and forth, so she can, you know, do a couple different poses with her hand, but then also it does twist as well, so you get that. You can make her fist, you know, go in different directions. You got her hand over here. This only hand she can hold the sword. She doesn't come with extra hands, unfortunately, to put the sword in the other hand. I wish that was an option, but that's okay. I mean, what she comes with is pretty good, and she does come with the big Venom leg, so we'll look at that here in a second for Monster Venom. So her accessory, you know, kind of counts as that as well. But again, leg joints, you got the ball joint in the leg, upper thigh swivel, knee joints in two places, of course. Then you also have a ankle joint that moves front to back, and then also on the ball joint side to side. But there's no swivel here in the thigh. So that's a big thing. So there's going to be a slightly limited posability with her, as there is with other characters. But I think the reason they did that was because they wanted to make sure the legs were strong to hold her up, because I notice a lot of the female figures, I think like my Black Cat, she falls over a lot. And I think it's because they put maybe too much articulation in her legs. So I think this helps out. This helps keeps Typhoid Mary balanced and makes her looking super awesome, as she should. And I like her hair. The hair mold on this is really great. They do a great job on the mold and the jeans with the belt buckle and everything. She's awesome. I think she has a slight chest. There's like a, you know, a swivel there in the chest, but no bend, like a little bit of bending, just a tiny bit. But again, they kept that mold solid there in her stomach, so she doesn't have as much articulation as some of the other characters. And obviously the head, she does have that on a ball joint. But I'll be honest, it's another one of those characters that I haven't really thought of ever buying a figure of, but because she was in the Venom line, I was able to pick her up. So kind of her and Spider-Ham are like the odd people out. They're the ones that I wouldn't normally go out of my way to pick up a figure of. But at the same time, they're included here, and I kind of like that I have them now. Now that I looked at them, they look pretty cool, and I think she looks great, and we'll look at Spider-Ham very shortly in an upcoming video. But from what I've seen in person now, I'm glad I have them. And knowing that I have a Daredevil figure that I can line her up with is also great too. And again, she does come with the Monster Venom leg, so we will look at that in a future video when we combine all the pieces together to show you what Monster Venom looks like. And we'll do a size comparison with him and the other characters. But let me know again what you think down below. If you have a favorite moment of Typhoid Mary in the comics, let me know what that is down below. And if you can pinpoint her costume and what version it is, if it is a version from the comics, let me know that down below too. Thanks for watching my video. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and we'll see you in the future. Peace.